Sometimes I get so mad, there's no control in me. My thoughts get so bad, I'm like, I might grab a bat, I don't know. My wrath, my blood boils over like, oh God, here goes. I lost all feeling from my head to my toes. You said some shit that I can't let go. So just stay tuned for the rest of the show. So have you
ever... Here we are, 6:30, Sunday morning. Camped about 30 k's from Chambers Pillar on the riverbed. Awesome spot. Quick walk around Warwick. Warwick's got the 32nd tent. Paul's got the Aldi special. Morning, Paul. Ben's got the pop-up type too. And Trev's got a pop-up one too. Very popular, these pop-up ones. Paul's got the fire going already. And I've got the RTT, which I've already packed up, sorry. You've seen it lots of times, though. Sunday morning and the cafe is open for business. I call this real coffee. I know it's in a pod, but it's real coffee. It's Paul replacing a missing bolt in the bash plate. Sunday morning, left camp, 8:30.
I posted up on the Y62 page about our fuel usage across the desert. There's always one person goes, gee, that seems high, I only used 150 litres last year.
So there, yeah, left camp, 8:30, a bit cloudy today.
Hoping maybe for he rain. Didn't do his numbers right.
Come back through the little town that I can't pronounce, and heading north towards Alice. We'll turn left before Alice, cut across country onto the highway, back down and out to Uluru. That's the plan anyway, we'll see how we go. Maybe for a pub lunch somewhere on the way, we'll see how time works out. Just pulled up about halfway on the track across from the Garn to the main bitumen highway. Oh yeah, this looks like the real track. River down there, might be some nice camping on that river. Gonna mark that spot.
Thank you.
down to 100. It feels like walk this fast. Like Paul's got a job to do at camp tonight. New trailer plug and cut.
Can you hear a car coming? We're at Mount Connor. Look out. Apparently we've got to walk up this hill and then we can get some good photos of the mountain and of the salt lake on the other side. It's a bit of a hike though.
Haven't we walked up enough sand
dunes? Nice salt lake. Opposite Mount Connor. Okay. Oh, they're not our car. These ones. These dirty ones are our group.
Still a fair way out of Uluru. The roads are getting wet. Looks like they've had a bit of rain out here. I can see blue sky in the distance. Well, we made it. We're here. What time is it? 5 to 4.
I'm stopping for a photo.
As you do. Welcome to Ayers Rock Resort, Eulara. So we're at Eulara Campground. We've checked in and I think we're out in the back blocks. We're just cruising through the campground. And we're in unpowered and overflow area. A little bit of space around, a lot of people here, though.
Warwick, whatever you do, don't lose your drink voucher.
Sounds like we've got a drink voucher. Red Dead area, alright? Nothing but dirt.
Here we are at Uluru Campground. Set up. Got our own kind of sort of semi-private area. It's private as it gets out here. Camped in the red dirt, praying for no rain. Otherwise it's going to be pretty sloppy out here.
Dinner at the pub.
and a beer. So we thought, oh, yeah, that's like tomorrow. Yeah, I don't know what's happening tomorrow, but like it'll be a early start.
Monday morning, heading down to the restaurant for brekkie. It's pretty quiet. Oh yes, we'll find a table in there.
I've seen it, a life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break.
So we're about 36 k's back out of Yalara. We're going to turn left here, head towards Kings Canyon. Kings Canyon. We're on the Red Center Way. Oh, look. Y62. There's one everywhere. Not the canyon itself, the resort. So we managed to score a room at Kings Canyon Resort. They're double bed. Get a double bed, little fridge. Three single beds. No toilets or amenities. They're in the amenities box just across the way there. Short walk. So yeah, we've got the park around the back here. The boys are down there too. We all got rooms.
Hello.
Only Trevor's camping.
And here's Paul walking past.
Hello, Neil.
Here's Paul. Paul's here too. He got a room as well.
I got in at the right time.
You got a room with a view. Canyon, heading for Alice Springs and a car wash. All roads are open. We're going to take the lady at reception suggested we take a shortcut of sorts, about 100 k's south of Kings Canyon. You can turn left and cut across country to the highway. So we're going to give that a go. On the road out of Kings Canyon, heading south. Dead straight, nice and flat. Howling a gale out there actually. Seeing the trees maybe. It blows you around a bit on the road. It's confusing. Speed limit on the left is 80 and on the right it's 110. Maybe you should drive in the right hand lane, I can go faster. I don't know what to make of that. Still heading south from Kings Canyon Resort, about 25 k's to our left hand turn. Cruise control on. Just cruising. 60 out, 1600 RPM. 6 PSI boost. Engine temp 87. Transmission temp 66. Basically just cruising. Exhaust temp 406. Chat about SIM cards and the phone. So I've got my physical SIM, which is a Telstra, and I've also got a Optus eSIM in there as well. Best of both worlds, I guess. At Kings Canyon, it says I had 5 bars of 4G, yet it didn't really work. And talking to the girl there, she said, yes, it says that on everybody's phone, but you're lucky to have 3G or any signal there from Telstra. But Optus was working not too bad. It was 3G, it was a bit slow, but Optus seemed to work fine. So that was interesting that it shows 4G, but you don't really have it. False advertising, Telstra. This may be our turn off here. Almost exactly an hour south of Kings Canyon. Springs. There we go. We'll take it. 100 to the highway. 100 kilometres of dirt. Oh, look at it. Gravel road. Look at that. It's only 98 kilometres now. We just saved 2 kilometres. Dry weather only. That's good. It's not raining. Signs here, beware. Loose surface, dust and corrugations. Standard dirt road. Slow down, double road. Yep, we're in the corrugations already. Whoa.
sand drifts and corrugations, 4x4 wheel drive. Very good. So we're on the what I call the shortcut road. And it's Giles Road. It cuts across from the bitumen to the bitumen. We're on the dirt. It's not too bad a road. A bit twisty and windy and plenty of 40k corners so far. Speed limit's 130. Dead straight, nice wide roads. Just cruising. Sarah to take some video for me on the passenger seat. Can you zoom in there a bit? That's 5th gear, we'll slow down a bit. That'll be 3rd gear, pull it up the hill. Fun begins. Let's get this mud off. Ah, oh, that's better. Ready for another dirty up. As you can see, there's a bit of crap on the ground here.
Yep.
Yes, yeah, something big hole or something.
Yeah, this was
awesome.
Yeah. Y62 is having a bath in Alice Springs.
As you can see, that dust storm in the middle of town. Here comes Paul.